McAllister dances before the king. Clansmen, the peats are burning bright. Set round in a ring and I will tell of that great night I danced before the king. For as a dancer in my youth, so great was my renown, the king himself invited me to visit London town. My brand new presentation kilt and ornaments I wore, and as with my ski and do, I rapped upon the palace door. And soon I heard the Lord or Duke come running down the stairs, who to the keyhole put his mouth, demanding who was there. "Open the door," I sternly cried, "as quickly as you can, if this is the way that you receive a Highland gentleman." The door was opened, word went round, "McAllister is here," and at the news the palace rang with one tremendous cheer. The king was sitting on his throne, but down the steps he came. Immediately the waiting lord pronounced my magic name. The lovely ladies of the court, with pearls and jewels decked, all blushed and trembled as I bowed to them with great respect. Slowly at first, with hands on hip, I danced with ease and grace, then raised my arms above my head, and swifter grew the pace. At last no human eye could see my steps so light and quick, and from the floor great clouds of dust came rising fast and thick. The king was greatly moved, and shook my hand in friendship true. "Alas," he cried, "although I king, I cannot dance like you." And then the gracious queen herself came shyly up to me. She pinned a medal on my breast for every one to see. Her whisper I shall ne'er forget, nor how her eyes grew dim. "Ah, where were you, McAllister, the day I married him?"